What's up guys, welcome back to Travel and Fun. I know it's been a long time since we have done a video. It's basically because of my work schedule that we haven't been able to do any videos as such, because I have been working in some shift practices these days. But yes, then tomorrow onwards we are going to be normal again, and maybe we'll come up with more videos soon. And this video is after a long time, and this one was already, like, you know, it was a teaser poster of this was already put out briefly. I guess it was around 2 weeks back that I'll be putting on this review of the all new Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G aluminium version, which is all made in India. Yes, this is the special factor about this fact that this watch is made in India. And considering this smartwatch competition here, I think that Samsung watch is the watch that is that perfectly competes with the Apple watch series. So basically they have all the good features that people normally wants to have. And yes, the one that I am wearing is the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G. So yes, talking about this watch is from Samsung, and specifically Samsung is also doing this thing that Samsung is making all of its smartwatches now in India. So it's a make in India, so it's a wonderful perspective from Samsung that they are making all their smartwatches in India, all of them, like all the Galaxy Watch, even the most recently announced Galaxy Watch 3 will also be, I think, will be mostly manufactured in India. So that's a wonderful thing for the Make in India campaign. Now talking about this watch, I have been like, you know, looking around for a good smartwatch for a number of days. I earlier had this Fossil smartwatch, but then it had some issues with the charging ports and all. They had these pin connectors in the charging ports. So after some months of use, these pin connectors, they got corroded, and unfortunately I couldn't charge them anymore. And if you go it for repair, it's out of warranty, and if I go for repair, I think it will cost more than the watch to repair it. So I was waiting, you know, to find a good smartwatch that would very well support Android. And since I am a Samsung smartphone user, I really love the Samsung Galaxy series, the S and Note series, that they are my favorites. So I have been using the S8, like my wife Anu, she has been using S8, we use Note 8, and now I am using the S10 Plus. So specifically being in the Samsung environment, I am specifically looking for something that would perfectly match the smartphone capabilities and the Samsung environment, you know what I'm talking about. Like Apple guys, they want to be in the Apple environment. They want iOS, they want Apple Watch, they want MacBook Pro. So it's like being in one closed environment and you feel safe and secure. That's the same thing with me. So when I'm with my Samsung phone, I feel that everything should be along with Samsung, you know, like I have my Galaxy Buds, I have my S10 Plus, and now I have my Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G. Well, yes, so this unit is made in India, as I told you about, and it's powered by Samsung's wearable Tizen OS 4. So you know that Samsung, in their smartphones, they use this Android, but in their watches they are still very much competent with other smartwatches and with their own Tizen OS. It's the wearable OS of Samsung, Tizen OS 4. And yes, this Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G, this comes in the 44mm version, and what I have is the LTE version, and it's aluminium, because the steel one costs a little bit more. I guess it costs around 35,000. So Samsung launched this watch, the Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G aluminium edition, some 2 months, 1.5 months back, at around 28,490, and they bundled it with some offers and all, like you had some cashbacks and stuff. So it was around at 28,490 this watch, and then I was able to purchase it at around 23,000, so with the cashbacks and all. So that was a very good offer from Samsung that they had. They don't have that offer right now, but if you go ahead and check Samsung's website, you will surely find some or the other offers keep running in Samsung's websites every now and then. Now talking more specifically about this watch, the technical specifications of this watch. This watch is having Wear OS is Android, Tizen Wearable OS 4.0, which is Samsung's particular capable OS for its wearable series. And this watch doesn't have a rotating bezel like the Samsung Watch had, but instead it has a very good haptic feedback. You still get the rotating bezel thing, but not with the actual physical bezel, but you can still hover your finger around the diameter of your screen and you will get that haptic feedback of a rotating bezel, physical bezel. So that's really nice. They have really so now you get more screen place, you know, so the screen is much bigger now. So you get this good haptic feedback when you use this bezel over here. And secondly, for this 4G version, so basically the steel version that Samsung had earlier, the 4G one, they had 1.5 GB of RAM, and the Bluetooth version, it had something less than 1 GB of RAM. So this version, the aluminium 4G version, also has 1.5 GB of RAM. It has 4 GB internal storage, and it is 4G compatible, and you can use it standalone as a 4G watch or as, you know, coupled with your smartphone along with Bluetooth. So for 4G, you need an Airtel or Jio postpaid connection. That's what I'm waiting for, because I'm waiting to get my Airtel postpaid connection. So once I am into the Airtel postpaid connection, I'll surely use it in the standalone 4G mode. But for now, I'm using it coupled with my Samsung smartphone along with Bluetooth. Now talking about the technical specs, this watch is capable of IP68. It's IP68 rated, so that means it can handle up to 5 atm of pressure and underwater. Yes, and then the other things is that it has a 360 by 360 pixels of display, which is quite bright, you know, and you also have this always on display feature, so you can also save your battery if you still want to keep your watch on when you are not looking at it. That means it looks cool, you know, and you can save some battery. But if you keep it completely off when you're not looking at it, you can save still more. And I have been using this watch for now almost, you know, like around 3 weeks around, and I perfectly love it. It's like the one smartwatch that I always wanted. It's round, this screen is round, and it's perfect. Like, it doesn't actually look like a smartwatch, so it looks like a normal watch, and you can use your, you know, normal any watch face that you want to, that is available from the Galaxy store. Yes, since this is Tizen based, you have to download the app faces or watch faces from the Galaxy store itself. You cannot have it from the normal Wear OS, you know, you cannot have those watch faces and all. But you have a very big collection of, you know, free and paid watch faces all along in the Galaxy store. So go ahead and check it out. And the other things that I have to tell you about is the physical appearance of the watch. The watch looks perfectly cool onto your hands. Like, I have this aqua black color option in my hand, and this was my choice. I really waited, and if I have to tell you a fact, it's that this aqua black version, usually it used to get sold out every now and then, so I used to keep watching and, you know, like when this will be available for purchase. So if you want the aqua black version, I would say, and if you like it, what I have reviewed here, if you like the watch, then you have to go straight ahead and check that notify me button in the Samsung store, and once it is available, you will be notified. And this looks really cool. The strap is not leather, it's a silicone based rubber strap, and the looks of the strap is really nice, and it's skin friendly also, so it doesn't have any particular irritation on your skin and all. And the watch face, the watch screen, the display is also quite bright and big, so you can easily swipe over and you can see much of the content. And one thing that is special about this watch is, this is what I like about the Samsung smartwatch, you know, it has all these features packed in. And I also heard that Samsung will be coming up this ECG feature, which is not to be used medically, just for an overview or for, you know, just for some basic diagnosis, you can use this ECG feature. But this will be coming soon to Samsung watches in India also, once the FDA approves it. So I think it's already approved in South Korea. So this will be also a very good feature. You also have heart rate monitoring continuous, or, you know, you can use it. I'm not going into, you know, much technical specs of this, just like a normal smartwatch user what you need. It can track all your fitness activities at one place. It has a, I think, around 39 or 40 fitness activities around, and you can select, I'm sure all of them must be doing among these 40 activities, so it has a lot of them to track. So you can go ahead, and since this is 4G, 4G version, you can go ahead and keep your smartphone at your home, and you can go for a run or exercise somewhere outside. You will be still connected to your 4G network, your SIM network. You have an eSIM here. you can pick and attend calls. You have a mic and a speaker, a very small speaker in the watch, which is quite audible. And I tried to review these things with some of my friends after calls with my family and all, and they couldn't really make out that I was talking from the mic on the watch or from the phone. So that's really good that you're not able to make it out. So that means it's giving a very good audio quality to the receiver at the other end. And talking about the buttons on the watch has just two buttons on the right side of the dial. One is for menu and the other one is for the power on and off. The menus and all I'll be showing you in the upcoming screen. So it's really beautiful, and you really have very, you know, menus that you can navigate easily. It's smooth, and the OS is really capable. Since you have 1.5 GB of RAM, I think the OS takes up around half GB of storage, and you have around still 1 GB RAM left for the rest of your activities on the watch. And talking about the physical storage, the on the device from the 4 GB, the OS also takes around 1 GB of storage memory, and the remaining around 3 GB you have it for storing songs or your playlist. And you know, it officially supports Spotify, so those who have Spotify connection can use directly Spotify app on your watch. Samsung Pay is somehow not available in India. I didn't find it, but there are many ways to do it, but I didn't try that. I will wait for Samsung to officially launch Samsung Pay in the Samsung smartwatch series in India, because the one feature that I love very much about Samsung's high-end phones is Samsung Pay. It's really useful. You have no need to carry your card or cash at any point of time. It runs in any machine, any swipe machine in any store, and only at places where you don't have a machine you have to go for cash, else Samsung Pay does your work. I don't think any other environment does this, so is so user friendly, and you also have reward points for that. That's why I like Samsung Pay a lot. So I'm waiting for Samsung Pay to come back to come to Samsung smartwatch series in India. So this is my review about Samsung smartwatch Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G. And talking about the battery life of this, which is one main aspect that when you use smartwatches. So the battery life for me, it lasted for around 2 days, because I am just using this watch for normal things, you know, like at times if you do some fitness activities at all, or if you go for a walk or something, and to monitor your heart rate. But I think one who does, you know, lots of fitness activities and exercises and all, it could last up to one full day with music and everything, and 4G connectivity activated. I think it lasts for Samsung says it can last up to 60 hours. I think it would last for around, you know, one and a half days. That's what I think, but I will be able to do that review only after I get a 4G connection on my watch and I use it completely standalone mode. So that's about the battery life. Rest assured, I am sure that the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2 will be a very good companion for you if you are in the Samsung environment especially. I would not recommend someone on the Android based environment, I mean stock Android, to use a Samsung watch. You can use it for fitness activities for sure if you install the Samsung Health app. So the watch and the Samsung Health app is very good, you know, I mean they perfectly synchronize with each other. You have all your data. If you wear your watch during your sleep, it even tracks your sleep. You can know how much of REM sleep you have, like how much time you have been dreaming, or how much time you have been having a good sleep. But practically speaking, I tried this for a few days, and then, you know, while sleeping I just took off my watch and I slept, because I don't feel it very comfortable to wear a watch and sleep. So it could take me some time to adapt to this, but yes, for now while sleeping I remove my watch. Rest of the time I always keep it here, and the heart rate monitoring also I keep it at, around every 10 minutes it keeps monitoring my heart rate. So this is my review about the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2. Overall, I would give this watch, for me, yes, it's a 5 on 5. I have never used an Apple Watch, and from the other reviews from Apple Watch, See, there's no point in comparing Apple Watch and Samsung Watch because they are both using two different operating systems. One is running on the Apple OS, iOS, and the other one is running on Samsung's own Tizen. And I think they both are equally providing you all the features and facilities that they can. And both are very good competitors against themselves. And I think these two are the most used smartwatches these days, which are really in the competition. And I think Samsung has a bit edge over the Apple Watch because of the lots of features that you have. You also have this wonderful feature where you can use your dress design, the attire that you wear a day, you can use that dress design as your watch face, and that's really helpful. I'll surely go ahead and show you how to do that, and that's really amazing. You can simply go ahead, click a photo of your dress from the Galaxy Wearable app. You can do that, and make sure you have this Galaxy Wearable app. So you need this to connect all your Samsung accessories, you know, like your Galaxy Buds, your smartwatch or fitness bands or whatever. You need this Galaxy Wearable app. So this perfectly synchronizes your watch and the phone, and it will also tell you, like, you can also change your watch faces from your phone. So you have to just click the photo of your dress from your Galaxy Wearable app, and then it will provide you some skins that will match your attire, and then that will be your watch face. I mean, your watch face will have that background. It's really cool, right? Yes. So these are some good things that I like about the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2. For sure, yes, they have come up with the Galaxy Watch 3 now, but I think that's even priced more. It almost has the same features as the Galaxy Watch Active 2, except for the new look and design and maybe a little bit of improvised features, but rest, I think the Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G will fulfill all your needs for a smartwatch. And with this, I hope you guys liked the video of my review of the Galaxy Watch Active 2 4G Aluminium Edition made in India. Yes, that's what I would like to stress every time, because I am very happy when things are made in India and Indian people are using it, and then the company makes profit out of Indian people using it, and the profit is also used in India. So it's really good for our nation. So let's use products made in India, and let's support these initiatives. So I hope you guys like the video, and I hope you will support our channel forever and ever. And if you like this video, make sure you like, share and subscribe to Travel and Fun. We will be surely coming up with few more travel videos, you know, lots of things coming up. It's raining heavily in Goa here. It's monsoon, and once the monsoon is, you know, it sets foot, you know, to a calm, we will surely move out again and we will start traveling, keeping all the safety precautions in mind. The pandemic is still on. So make sure you like, share and subscribe to our channel. And again, we apologize for the delay in posting our video. Hence on, we'll make sure that we post videos as fast as we can. So until we see you the next time, it's bye from me.